Can you smile to your neighbor by your side? Say the Lord bless you tonight. I am happy to see you around. Your life will never be the same again. Can you assure your neighbor? Say, God bless you tonight. I am happy to see you around. Your life will never be the same again. If you believe that, clap your hands one more time for Jesus. We want to bless God for tonight. This is our usual deliverance encounter. And I believe that as you have come to this place tonight, every prayer you pray, God will answer to your prayers in Jesus' name. We want to receive God's word and then we go to a time of prayer. If there is a man to pray, there is a God to answer. He said in Jeremiah, call unto me and I will answer. And those of you who are good in English language, they will tell you that the word will is a definite article. He did not say I may or I might answer. He said I will. It is of certainty. It is of certainty. I will answer when you call unto me. And he didn't stop there. He said, and I will show you. May God show you things tonight in Jesus' name. May God expose things to you tonight in the name of Jesus. One of the things I keep loving God for every day is that He shows me things. I will not just answer you, I will show you great and mighty things which thou knowest not. You know, the secret to victory, listen to this. The secret to victory is when you know the weakness of your enemy. When you are fighting a battle that you already identify the weakness of your enemy, you get an edge over the enemy. In every exam, some of you are in school. When we are in school, there is what they call leakage. Leakage. What is leakage? Leakage is getting the question of an exam before the exam. Am I correct? And listen to me. When I was in school, there is no way for us, I'm not talking about everybody, for us, there is no way we can have the leakage and fail the exam. Because you prepare us for the exam. If you know that, there are some people that can still have the leakage. And they still have F. I've been to exams that they say it's open book exam. How many of you have been to such exam? They said it's open book exam. Some people can still fail. The book is open, yet they fail. Do you know why they fail? Because if you check them, they will not obey to the notes. Some are not even getting the notes. So when the question comes, I for answer. You get the book, but you don't get anything. You don't get the notes. You can get the book, but you don't get the notes. So tonight, I pray one more time for somebody listening to me. May God open your eyes to see the condition of your life. Say, I will show you. Lift up your right hand and say, Lord, show me tonight. Say, whatever I need to know for my life to change, whatever I need to know for my level to change, whatever I need to know to change my destiny, whatever I need to know to settle my matter, show me tonight in the name of Jesus. Knowledge is power. Daniel said, for the people that do know their God, they shall be strong and they shall do exploits. Knowledge is power. Somebody said to me the other day that the more you know, the more you become. And if you don't know, you will be unknown. If you don't know, you do what? If you don't know, nobody will know you. The world is looking for people that have answers to questions. This world is not looking for people to pity. Even United Nations, now lie than the lie, they are not looking for people to pity. They are looking for answers. So the reason why some countries are relevant, some are useless, is the capacity of their knowledge. One more time, I pray for 49 people. May God open your eyes to see your condition in Jesus' name. The day God showed me my life, I stopped joking with my Christian life.
Mommy, did they God show me my background? My background. Every man has a root. Somebody said, I have a root. Every man, sir, you get what is that? You get a root. You, there is a place you are coming from. No man is an island. No man stands alone. Nobody just appear. There is no Melchizedek in our generation now. The only person I know that Bible tells me has no background, no father, no mother. Go and read Hebrews chapter 7. You see. The day I read that scripture, I've been asking God, who is that? Which kind of a guy is this? There was no trace of his background. And he was the king of Salem. The king of peace. Can I show you? That man Bible talks about is Jesus himself. He is from the root of David. But all of us today, we have a background. Mommy, sometimes when God shows you your background, you'll be serious with your life. That's why, yeah, this is not my message. That's why, mommy, you see two people sitting down in church. Mommy, the one go serious, they pray, but yet he has trouble. The one go kalokalo, but he still go before. You know the reason? The one with kalokalo, sometimes background no bad better. So he like you not pray better. In life, still they go smooth. Mommy, you go they pray that you watch what they will know they pray better. You the one, how comes they don't think they work for them past me? It's as a result of the foundation. Psalms chapter 11 verse 3 says, if the foundation is destroyed, what can the righteous do? Lift up your hand and say, Lord, tonight, show me what I need to know to get out of poverty. Say, Lord, tonight, show me what I need to know to get rid of stagnation. Say, Lord, tonight, show me what I need to know to eliminate shame. Say, my God, my Father, open my eyes tonight. Show me what I need to know to escape with gold. In the name of Jesus. It is, sir, there is one thing God will show you that will be the key to your next level. One thing that God shows you, level will change without stress. I keep saying to people, hear this now. Not everything you need in life, you must be stressful for. Mommy, life is too short to be full of stress. Even those who live 70 is short. You think 70 years is long? Mommy, some people will live 40 full of stress till they die. Like I keep saying to the church, there are some people, mommy, their lives are so full of stress. Mommy, that some people, even for buy credit, it will stress for them. For put credit in my phone, it will get up. Then here and 500 coin you give. You begin one, I will send this for buy land. If for buy credit, it will get up. So such people, they will end up living 60 wasted years full of stress. Because the secret, the key to their next level, was knowledge. Someone say knowledge. Bill Gates is not a Christian. Look at me. Is Bill Gates born again? Mommy, do you know why Bill Gates is at that capacity? It's knowledge. His eyes were open to something that nobody knew. The more you know, the more you become. If you want to be great in life, go for what others don't know. Get the solution that others cannot produce, and the world will go after you. One more time, I pray for 101 people.
Yes,
in your family, the secret to the next level in your family.
Yes,
may you be the one to reveal it in Jesus' name. I can't be in my family, and my family is still in darkness. I must bring light to my generation. Because of knowledge. Somebody say knowledge.
Amen.
Let me go to my message tonight. Sit down. Because we have a lot to pray about tonight. I want to minister, ladies and gentlemen, tonight on the subject I titled Activating Your Breakthrough. Activating your what? Activating your breakthroughs. Many people have missed out in their seasons of breakthrough because they lack understanding. There are many sufferers today as a result of lack of understanding. And like I said to you all the time, Your understanding will make you outstanding. Hosea chapter 4, verse number 6. He said, for my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, not for lack of connection. You know, someone feels that a connection will make you better. No. You don't need connection to succeed. You need knowledge. Somebody say knowledge. For my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. A lot of people miss their seasons of breakthrough because they lack understanding. The source of Issachar, Bible said they had edge over their brethren because they knew they had understanding of the times and seasons. And because of the Bible said their brethren were at their command. May you be the one leading your generation in Jesus' name. May your generation be at your command. Understanding gave them an edge over everybody. Their brethren were at their command because of understanding. A lot of people miss out when it is their season of breakthrough because they lack understanding. Breakthrough is the meat of God's people. Breakthrough is the food of every children of God or every child of God. God is pleased when you experience breakthrough. God has no pleasure when things are not working for you. Jeremiah, I read it just now, 29:11. He said, I know the thoughts that I think towards you. God has no pleasure when you are poor. In fact, listen to this. You don't represent God well in poverty. Now imagine, we are preaching about Jehovah Jireh, the God who provides, yet you can't cook for the day. Can you be a better representative of God? Let me give another physical example, John. Imagine the ambassador of America in Sierra Leone is in the Sierra Peace and Olive Tree in a very physical middle life. Believe you me, they say this looks like I've ever seen. Because the nation you represent cannot be begging on the way. If humanly speaking, no ambassador of a nation can beg, how can an ambassador of heaven beg food? I came tonight to cause poverty in your life. Every beggarly spirit that is Allah's in your family, that is Allah's in your life, may you escape me tonight in the name of Jesus. Psalm 37, verse 25. David said, I have been young. He said, now I am old. Yet, I have never seen the righteous forsaken. I have never seen his children begging for bread. These are the language of those who know the God they serve. I have been young, now I'm old. I have never seen God forsaking the righteous person. I have never seen their children begging bread. I don't know the last time you were in the corridors of people begging them, but I come tonight to declare to you, that will be your last time to beg in Jesus' name. Let me come over here. I said, I don't know the last time you go to people's house to beg them. That will be the last time you ever beg in the name of Jesus. The thoughts I think towards you, they are of peace. They are of good and not of evil, to give you an expected end. Your end will be better in life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say you will end well in life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
But understand this, ladies and gentlemen, before we pray tonight. Understand this, that there are powers assigned to resist your breakthrough. Mommy, there are powers that have been designed to resist the breakthroughs of people. 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 9. 1 Corinthians 16, verse 9. Admonishing the Corinth church, the church was, he said, a great and effectual door is open. There is a door that God has opened. He said, but before you cross that door, there are many adversaries. There are many people, mommy, who are standing at the door. They said, Sarah, you will come close, but you can't cross. I don't know who are those people standing before the door to your greatness.
Yes,
I don't know who are those people standing before the door to your destiny.
Yes, sir.
May God crush them tonight in the name of Jesus. Their assignment is to stop the breakthrough. Their duty is to make sure your life becomes a subject of mockery.
Those who are waiting to see your shame, your fail, your reproach, they will wait in vain in Jesus' name. I said they will wait in vain in Jesus' name. The devil will never sit quiet and see God's children have a beautiful life. He will always in tool to cause a breakdown. Look at someone by your side, say no more breakdown. Can you look at the person in the eye and say no more breakdown? Look at the person and say, as long as you are here tonight, you are not permitted to break down in life again. Lies up and points to 5 people and tell them, as long as you are in church tonight, you are not permitted to break down in life again. As long as you are in church tonight, you are no longer permitted to break down. No more break down in your life again. You are no longer permitted to break down. You will not permit. You will not be a break down in life again in the name of Jesus. You are no longer permitted to break down. Somebody say, I shall never break down. Hey, come on, say it with me. Say, I shall never break down. I don't know which area of your life is breaking down. I don't know the damage the devil has caused to your life and destiny. I stand upon this altar and I decree,
yes,
every breakdown to your business,
yes,
every breakdown to your family life,
yes,
every breakdown to your academic life,
yes,
every breakdown to your settlement,
yes,
every breakdown to your traveling,
yes,
may it begin to stand away in the name of Jesus. Nothing will break down in your life again. One more time, say to yourself, say, I can never break down again. Hit your chest and tell yourself, I can never break down again. I can never break down in life again. I can never, no matter what, I am not permitted to break down again. So tonight, I beg you to get yourself ready to pray. Because I'm going to show you what God said to me about this breakthrough. Somebody say, I shall breakthrough. Come on, somebody say, I shall pray too. As I prepare my message tonight, God said to me, tell my people that if they must experience breakthrough, there are two things I want you to share with them. If you must experience this breakthrough and never break down, there are two major things you must take to mind. Number one, light and all. The first thing God said to me, hear this. God said that if you must experience breakthrough, number one, you must stay with the word of God. You must stay with the word. Tell someone, say, stay with the word. What the word says about your life. Listen, as you walk closely with God, you will understand that your confession is very important. In fact, I keep telling you that confession brings possession. Confession brings possession. What you say is what you say. Jesus was preaching, and Jesus said, let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say. Do you know that if it were in our days, they say a false lie? If I did, and that's why they talk. What's your post? If I'm a gentle, he said, it's of a bush. Like you, sister. Then they call it of a bush. But this was Jesus speaking. Do you know why? Because Jesus knew, if you must be rich, don't speak poverty. You are permitted to be born in a poor family, but you are not permitted to die poor. No. Because my mother is poor, does not mean I should die poor. Because my background is poor, does not mean I should live in poverty. Am I talking to somebody? So speak what the word of God says about you. Don't speak your condition. Don't speak what you see. Tell somebody, say, speak the word, speak the word. Come on, say, speak the word. Change your language and your life will change. I love that statement. Change your language and your life will change. Pastor Chris Oyakhilome was preaching one day, and Pastor Chris said that words are like bullets. He said when they are released, they look for the target. Watch me, mommy. Sometimes when you speak the positive words, you might not see it happening in the physical. But he said, keep saying it. People around you might be saying that this is a big talking about big mouth. Keep telling yourself that you are going somewhere. Somebody say, I'm going somewhere. Say, I am a bundle of success. Say, I am destined to succeed. Say, I am not a local champion. Say, me not a pepper boy. I'm not going to die from poverty.
Ces mille vont tomber des morts, alors vos dames des forts. Speak what the word says, not what is happening around you. Very sad story. We that didn't know the person you want to talk about. I'm glad he work in the same area. So he don't say, but I don't say remember the person. Within I place in Abu Fields, within number 67, number 66, they get a guy for more small. He was a Wesleyan member by the name of Bundu. Bundu was a cripple. Mommy, I don't forget in the 90s, the first away that monkey cancer alone. I was small, 1991. Mommy, Bundu, we know him from where born as a cripple that uses a crutch to walk. Very intelligent guy, an intellectual, a graduate from the university. Mommy, and one day, they said that monkey is coming to Sierra Leone. Mommy, people went to the crusade. Bundu went with his crutch. All of a sudden, I think it was the final night, as Renabonke was praying for the sick. He said, wherever you are, if you are sick, get ready for the touch of God. If you are a cripple, get ready to rise up and walk. And mommy, as the Renabonke was praying, all of a sudden, Bundu dropped his crutch and he was still standing. He said, how comes? Mommy, and he sent the first foot, the foot go, not you happy. Mommy, sent the second foot, the foot go. Bundu began to walk without a crutch. Mommy, it was a scream. Everybody was shouting. Watch, they said it was time for testimony. Bundu went down to testify. Mommy, as Bundu was testifying, somebody that was in the Bufils community, he saw Bundu. He said, I don't believe saying that Bundu this. That cannot be Bundu. Mommy, the person went well, not in order, and I said, can't go outside the testify. He go wait me and he said, can't be testimony. Mommy, everything was gone. Bundu was doing well. Bundu, you know, those times, mommy, when we get that stage, then that way they use their mental, and I bold them in the building. They are then bolded. So, Bundu can't down the bold stairs, taken down on his own. As soon as he was coming out of the gate to enter the stand, he met this lady standing. He said, Bundu, I can't wait for conviction. Bundu, now you this, now you know when? Mommy, the sooner the person asks him the question, then Bundu said, hey, wait for solar each house. But the sooner he made the statement, if he went down, bam, he became a cripple again. And the lady just turned him back and went far. The testimony of a man was aborted because of wrong confession. What he again you wait for? You don't even testify. You don't see what in God do. You say, let I wait till I reach my house. It shows you are not grateful to God. But can I shock you, mommy? Somebody was planted to terminate the destiny and the testimony of that young man. As I speak to you, till today, mommy is walking with a crutch. Mommy, this, listen now, mommy. This is about 1991 to now. Is it not 29 years? 29 years. Last year, I saw Bundu light around PZ. He was turning with his coach. Anytime I see the guy, the first thing that will come to my mind, this was a testimony where this man before, you know, over 29 years ago, a demon from hell changed the man into a man. How? By a confession. Listen to me before we pray tonight. If you don't guard the way you speak, if you listen now, Bible said death and life lies in the power of the tongue. This is where we stop, but that's not the end of the scripture. They say, and they that love each shall eat the fruit. So the fruit is determined by what you speak. You speak positive, you eat good food. You speak negative, you eat bad food. Help me tell someone, say, guard your tongue, guard your tongue. Tell her back, you say, you want my problem, you want. Tell her fine, say, the problem is your life, you want. God said to me, mommy, God said, tell people that if they must walk into the abysses of breakthrough, they must guard their tongue. They must speak what the word says, not what they see. Some of you, if you find out what you ate, they tell you, you're not ever married. Mommy, I'm telling you, some of you here, sincere as I speak to you now by revelation, some of you, even when you are alone, the devil will keep reminding you that my life, you are married. Are you married lifetime? I see you have the time. Are you people ever married? I see you have the name married you.
Mommy, if you keep listening to those voices, you can never believe God will bring to you. Speak what God said, not what your mind is telling you. I was never a pastor, but yet I knew that my life is going somewhere. I was living a wayward life, but every time you talk to me, sir, I will tell you that before I die, I am going to shake my generation. I am a generational shaker. Even when and God overheard it, I'm saying, and God said, as you say it, I will do it. Speak the word. Tell someone, say, speak the word. Speak the word. Forever, O Lord, thy word is settled in heaven. It is settled. Not my word, not the words of my enemies, not even the words of my parents. Thy word is settled. If God said I'm blessed, nobody can curse me. If God said I'm a success, nobody can make me a failure. If God said I will break camp and advance, no power can limit me. Thy word is settled. There is a way a child of God speaks. You don't say no until they talk.
Yes, sir.
So number one, God says speak the word. Someone says speak the word. And hear this now. Tell me. If you don't know the word, you can't speak the word. You can't give what you don't have. It's a basic principle. You can't give what you don't have. The reason why some of you, when you dream which one against the money that was covered your toes for cost for because I see you, you mama. As you God will give it to me, I'm like it in a you speak that kind of language because you lack the word. People who know the word, they don't fight witches. You know, I don't know some people that put that myth, they say, wait, curse witch, my mama. I must find that in that thing. They say, wait, curse him, mama, if they come up with. No, they fool at you. Where's the mommy curse never knows witch, man? And I imagine the more you curse him, mama, the more you suck in the beginning. They say, well, they deal with you quicker now. But the cost will cost me. But when you meet somebody when you get the word, he said, for we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities. When a child of God has such a thing, when he wakes up the next morning, can two kungu talan to cover in kuta tiko kayana. You change level and the devil know that he might know it in the back. Tell you never say you need the word, you need the word. You can't speak the word if you lack the word. Matthew chapter 4. Bible said that the Spirit of the Lord led Jesus. The Spirit of the Lord led Jesus to the mountain to be tempted by the devil. The Spirit of God, mommy. Listen, you know sometimes when you read Bible, you want to say, is this correct? The Spirit. Jesus was led up of the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. And mommy, all of the temptation Jesus faced, he never argued the devil. He said, if you are the Son of God, turn these stones to bread. Jesus looked at Satan and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone. But Jesus understood that what the enemy is afraid of is the amount of war that is in you. Watch me. That's why, read this thing for me. Read that for me. That's why if you watch, please look at me. If you watch all our banners and everything as a church, at the end, we have it there. God gave me this word in Port Harcourt, Nigeria. God said to me that, James, your word level is your God level. If now 5% word you get inside you, now 5% word that you get inside. Many years ago, I then an other country, I was talking to Ibadan. God said, hey, forget about this joke. Your word level is your word level. The reason why, mommy, two Christians face the same temptation, the one overcome, the other one they overcome, and the word will inside them. Jesus said, the peace of this world comes, but he has nothing in me. What is in me is the word. Jesus said to him, it is written. He took him to the high mountain. He said, just fall down. He said, for God will give his angels charge over you. He said, you will not dash your foot on this rock. Do you know what that means? He said, you are a fool, stupid. He said, you should not put the Lord your God. into it. And Satan said, ah, the guy, tell me this about him. He took him to the other mountain and showed him all the glory of the world. And Satan said, all what you see, they are mine. Satan came back. He watched me one word. He said, wait, I'll show you soon. Let me get it. He said, just bow down and worship me. He said, and I will hand over all of this to you. Jesus watched Satan. He said, my man, before you were, I was. He said, for it is written, thou shalt worship no other God. And Bible says, at that point, Satan knew that this is a man that has the war on the inside. Bible says, and he left him for a season. If Satan must live your life, you must be a carrier of the world. Help me ask somebody by side. So almost one way inside you. But who Christian backslide you in Corona because you don't get word? Yesterday I was with a pastor and the pastor was complaining to me. What the pastor said? He said that the one thing they shocked me. He said, but who man where Corona be the moment they say that church still open? The church don't be nice, the legal church. Almost by notice. Hey, almost by guess them here you. When are they going to say, ah, we miss church? Ah, the people are so bad about government this. They be a lucky government, mother, and they God go vet me for me. Now, they say, okay, we're go. So, I say, you already know the
God, God said they want their land.
Beyond that, lie, so I'm not mommy, all that man go, man go, so I'm not I know you mean them at all. That's why, even when the church is now open, some people are still taking time to watch their movie in the house. One more time, help me ask your neighbor. Say, almost God in what will inside you. Tell that Creo, say, I don't say you're bonified. Say, I don't say you're sabidious. Say, almost God in what will inside you. Not when you style like a castle. Now it is almost God in what will inside you. Mommy, some man at church where they swagger, inside in a carcass. Jesus said, they are like whitewashed tomb. Dead bones that they full up inside them. They are like the sepulchre that is full of dead men bones. You look at it for me, the entire adobo inside. And blah, blah, blah. We are big. Hey, yeah, hey, Corona, the living tree. You are not looking neighbor, not slap our boy, say slap her. Look you neighbor near you. Say, how inside they? How inside? Tell them for me, say, I'm not saying you dress fine. I'm not saying you body fine. I'm not saying you ain't chicken. Say, but sister, how inside they? How inside they? If you are confronted by pressure, what will be your response? Pastor Kamal, why do you think some lady can fall at the bed of a man because of technocide? Inside empty. A lady was preaching in my church. I've been sharing this in this church. A lady was preaching, a woman pastor. Some of you used to know her, Agnes Bondi. She was preaching here many years ago. She made a statement that till today, but can they forget? He said, it's so pathetic. That people when they say marry God, they say, but how married within a church? They say, well, if they say, even cheeky, they are pastor now. Yes, mommy. They say, go to a big market. So, cack the day, mommy, will take 70,000. Are you correct? So, five cack, 110,000. They look at, they say, pastor, they say, me a woman, now 5,000 credits, you give me. 5,000 credits. And mommy, look at me. Men do not place value on what is cheap. If a man can get you at 10,000 and he bites you, not to cost you, that man can never see you as a wife. Men look for things that they struggle to get. And it will not suffer for anger but be able to respect a man. If a man, listen up, if a man can have you without annoying you, say understanding. Now, how understanding they left you. Back, let me tell you about you. You hear that talking there? You say, now, wait, nah. Now, what is this? I don't understand. You're not discussing. And so, we can't understand it. So, I'm ready for God. I'm ready for taking excuse. You back, go understand. I'll say, mommy, anything a man is not paying a price for, they will not put value on that thing. What is your value? The reason why many people are cheap is because inside is empty. Mommy, when you carry the word, watch me, man. You might not be the most beautiful lady in church, watch me. But a guy can go around every other girl when it comes to you, they will know this is my bus stop. I might not be the smartest around, but I am a woman of integrity. What you carry inside will determine how you display on the outside. In our day, women, be a me, they can't pray. Tell you, if I say, be a pastor. Yeah, because of man they cost me in my hands right now. Be a me. Mommy, this is the fact. What you carry inside will determine how you behave on the outside. See the way some people behave, mommy. Someone, the man, not actually the man, never, you call me. You must have been mad. Mommy, you must have been mad. I gave you the other day, but I tell you now. Say, if I tell you almost months, we were angry. Mommy, the thing he asked me, I almost want to give up. But I don't give me to any member. I say, oh, this is the bigger right. The bigger right. For tell you, say, no matter who you think you are, I have a place that I am that you can't get to me easily. I go to Leonstar, South Africa, na stadium. For me, I sit down at the crowd, na stadium, no stadium on floor. This lady didn't hear me. I don't have here, I first am it. So let me the first place, I can't sit down here, Pastor Peter. The lady take phone, they call. Hello, hey, we call it, hey. And they hear the way they talk, because the place warned me. And they call the bossy, I don't know what message one here. Incredible. That's it, I say, madam, call the bossy. Hey, thank you, sir. Now he tell me, say, that is number for me. Now that is number we give you. Now I call the bossy. Why is he calling the bossy? Wait, me attention, lady. I know if you don't say, don't talk, though. They don't take any number. Put it inside the phone. They don't play an inside. Let them know. Mama, we just don't collect the phone. We can house. Mommy, next by 1 o'clock morning. Now before we give, bring. And the one that was normal this morning, I'm doing, hello, how are you? Fine, sir. How are you, sir? Fine. I said, now where they talk? Another lady will be empty in the stadium. You're a very nice guy. Mommy, I pause first. And I say, yes, thank you. That's how you get to know my sister. Sorry, I'm not going to let you know. But after I talk to the boss, and I dial, I put my number inside the phone, and I flash myself. So that you don't have to let me inside the phone, so that I can go for talk to you. And I let you. You know, I see you, I see you in nice, that kind of thing they ask for sin. I say, the devil will punish you. Also, God will, the devil will punish you. You just do. Hey, mommy, can I shock you? If I were any kind of a person, it entertain you. You see, and what we call you. And I didn't kind of thing, mommy, if they pray in a church, they can sit and kill them. If they chuck crap and pray in a church, if you see them, Papa, the pastor. Say, watch me, sir. From that 1 o'clock late, pastor, 10 morning, mommy, between the one through my mind, what was going to my mommy? How can somebody be so cheap? That you are the one, mommy, even if sincerely again just over you, that day you don't lose your survival. You just don't lose your waiting, you survival. Anything somebody do not, it shows the state of the lady that inside is empty. One more time, lift up your hand, say, Lord, fill me with your word. Say, Lord, from today, fill my life with your word. I refuse to be empty. Fill me to the overflow. In the name of Jesus. Number two. Number one, I say what? You must stay. Finally, number two, God said, if you must break through, number two, you must persevere. Be a man or a woman of perseverance. When I was in school, they taught me that if at first you don't succeed, try again. They say, if again you don't succeed, keep on trying. In the end, they say you will succeed. If only you try, and try again. The family that invented the electric bulb light system, I think they call them the Einstein family or so. Hear this, everybody. Mommy, the family that invented this light we are seeing, we are told in school that they failed 99 times. How many of you do physics as well? They failed 99 times, mommy, making 100 and get time. And the light now they enjoy so. Mommy, imagine if along the line they say, ah, this one says, not today God wants to. Mommy, one of the reasons why white people, they are inventors more than blacks, is because of perseverance. They will never stop at failure. Corona, watch me. Corona, they make. They say Tanzania gets, how you call that drug? The African drugs. Say get the bush. They get the African herbs for a. Watch me. Wait, man. And they, before this year, I go to the February for a man. They just can't be satisfied with failure. No matter the challenge, they will always rise up for it. Africans will not persevere. Even Christians in church, we claim we believe God, but we lack perseverance. God said, if you must break through, you must persevere. To persevere, that is wisdom. To persevere means to persist steadfastly. To persist steadfastly. In spite of distraction, in spite of discouragement, in spite of difficulty, you must persist steadfastly. To persevere means to persist. You keep knocking until the door is open unto you. Jesus gave a story, I think it is Luke 18, about the widow and the unjust judge. Jesus said, he said, this is a lesson you must learn as a believer. This judge do not fear man, neither have regard for God. But because of the persistence of the woman, the judge said, this man, not care what he wants, he will kill me. And when we look at how Jesus said, Jesus said, if a mere mortal can guess when person keep knocking, how much more your heavenly Father? There are some of you that watch me now. You don't speak in a church this night. Church just open. You don't miss church more. Wait by the time we go next month, we do. Now Sunday to Sunday, I leave the rich. You don't turn Sunday to Sunday Christian. Perseverance is needed if you must build through. I used to give that example in church. God forbid, you, all of you know me in church. I'm not a politician. President Madabio became a president because of perseverance. Then boss you know, almost like remember. Hey, but you don't make it public, almost like remember all they want me. When I showed him last time, I was like, you know.
Say, look here, you love your photo.
For me, imagine what many of us we are talking, mommy. Somebody talking, ah, this God no one will be president. Not by force. Not a...
Man, I say, yeah, I'm here soon. What happened against
you? All my camp! You cannot come and say, I'm missing, but you are next. I need to talk to you. If you don't want to see, I don't see my beer. Who's that? Who is it? You don't want to see, I'm there. Mommy, the man ended in a connection to you. Whether all of us will like him or not, God saw his perseverance and God said, I will give you a chance. Mommy, when you persevere in life, God will give you an occasion to display yourself. The reason why many of us fail, not to not demon they be away. Now you make that talk to soul. You don't kill demon, you almost don't die. What? You never say almost don't die, you almost don't die. They say persevere, you never kill demon every week. Make a never agree with the work. Later in the day, ask your papa, hey, you want the guy you better want to kill. What did they die? Now what's going to be later in the day? You want to give news. What's in there? Hey, you want to copy that guy. More in the day for fun. More in the day for fun. According to more in the day for fun, about 74,444 in the day. What do they see money? You don't kill 74,000. You don't see money. Who say you kill 74,000 men who don't see the body? The man just they kill them once. How did they kill us when they can't hear what I wrote? They kill them all. Then they reach their feet over. The guy will just fast in and give you confidence. And he dead. Where is the music? There is a concrete report from why Nana Fofana. He said, hey, this guy, I also like the light of here. That guy left life, but we tell the rich that will watch. All the one they went there, I will not see them. Now they don't catch him up before me now. Why not? I will not talk again. Hallelujah. Let me tell some of you, say persevere. Tell the person, say, even if you have failed before, say, don't stop at failure. Rise up and continue your journey. say you will surely get to your destination. Tell another person, say, even if you have failed before, say, don't stop at failure. Rise up and continue your journey. Say, you will get to your destination. You will get there if you persevere. Is that all since what's 14? That was again. Sister, go sit back. I don't sit 5 now. For, go sit back. I've been sharing with you on a church now. Somehow we're going to discourage you. Joel, stand up. I'm happy you had to be. Stand up. This time your mama can be telling about. What tell us? The pressure will this young man gets for Lego soldier. Am I correct, sir? The pressure, he don't sit. If most of the one way don't sit, sit. Hey, but I don't go. Don't go back. You want me to tired. But go soldier. Okay, then. One day now look at you, don't be giving me this. I say you the way you be lying. You go to them and slap. If I want to see you, in they fire you, in they slap people like you just see me. I say, don't tire. No, so that's how you mean for me. For me, every for even you. Finally I said no. Even if because you don't pay, come to me, I'll pay. But you must get here. And for me, as I talk to you, the man don't finish you, but if I tell you you can't walk away, God don't be this young man. For me, Sunday, what I can see, I want to shock me. Imagine if you accept. This work, all they do, I'm not saying not like that. Out of the work we get, if I tell you how many foreign currency they can give for this work. This is not the most of them who are going to go pay 1 million to 100. Don't they cost us? Say, go to that. See now. Perseverance make one young man make up his mind say, I will not stop at failure. I mean, you can't hold the copy. In fact, when you persevere, mommy, so my baby will go to you, but you need to have a seat to ask her. You tell them to be using the cabinet at Kamara. I can tell you, say, I'm going to go to the next. Don't you say, hey, not too late. Maybe I'm going to use me for hours. Tell you, that's what, mommy, these are people that we call destiny destroyers. The assignments, my dear, is to frustrate you not to get to where you should get to. Tell someone, say, even if you have failed. Look at someone by saying, say, even if you have failed before. Say, don't stop at failure. Rise up and continue your journey. Say, you will get to your destination. Jam your hands together for Jesus. Don't stop there. Don't stop. Look at my wife. I don't know why I'm giving all this for me. This place we are today, that God is helping us, all of what people are seeing. When we came to this place 8 years ago, it was this very young man and some people that they can't help me. Look at, look Pastor Jordan. You know how status is she also my year? We will not even get money for my chair. Now block me, now we pack. Then no man block when the bill for me. Now we pack four with crossbow. Then I bench. We don't see my pastor defense is better. We see, you know, I say, we see. So remember, they say, we see. We say, Pastor, but this is not the receipt. If I go over, Pastor, you'll get side for chemical. I say, take it. You see, Pastor, remember, they better. I say, yeah. Oh, yeah, now that's who they are. Remember. Take it, Papa. You see, the carry service, you know, you say, take it. I'm the first member in a church for the follow. Remember, I can see me on small. I tell you the truth, mommy. Man, what the female pastor is me and my wife. Mommy, my wife, where they go, they come for can't go evangelize. My wife, they work at this bamba in Laclemia. The other day, mommy, they come up bridge and back up. Now, talk to the back of my head. When they come, so you can't see. Mommy, and in my heart, God was saying to me, you will tell this story one day. Mommy, the people we met in the community, they look at us, they say, Pastor, you are not fighting for church. If I see, you are open now. For how much Christian? God promised the Lord. People that we can know, he said, not fight for church. Count mercy. Mommy, and I said to this boy, I said, I can never stop at failure. Mommy, come back. Inside this place, this small buffer, the one of church, and before me, to the second pillar, I don't cut. Now, buffer, mommy, I don't know if you get money for my man. Now, tapole, I lamp the money, and tapole, I don't go. Mommy, did you want, you know, to make out? Now, all go, look, Pastor John. Pastor John, I told the carpenter, all bold, now what, we join, we battle, okay, our bold. For me, and inside that, I believe that I didn't want to pray. The guy here, the pastor, is good. And then you give me the police, and you want laugh, they laugh. This pastor, I ain't the Chris. And I'm even the same Chris. Oh, but the way I laugh at the guy, well, moon! Yeah, I'm gonna lie! The guy, well, moon! I say, well, he meets you at the WAP. The big man like me, now you say, I had the Chris. So you mean God bring me up, okay? I don't want to be pastor of prayer, the government prayer, God, you not call me for killing me. Papa, this time, you pray that prayer, Papa, God, you not call me for killing me. You not call me for killing me. Oh, the man said I had a cat case. Papa, no, you not call me for killing me. For me, I held on to all of the pressure. Pay attention, sir. I held on to the pressure of the I held on to the pressure of me when God saw that this guy was determined. Sir, inside the tarpaulin, and they are all defense if they want me. And I made the prayer to God. I said, God, if I come by this secular field now, if now you send me. This same place when I say, oh, church, they woke. Prove yourself to me. But we saw when they are passing now, you know what they are saying? Ah, they are the international connection. They don't know that the heavenly connection bit. Someone say perseverance. Matthew chapter, so Mark chapter 5. I'm ending with that subject. Mark chapter 5 from verse 25. Bible gave us a story about the woman with the issue of blood. Bible said for 12 good years, she was bleeding. Every time I can share this, I can tell her. But maybe not to a woman. But I tell you the truth. I don't dare alarm my mama one day. When my mama, he didn't tell me his late stepdaddy. He didn't have no story. So I go pass in a young belly and say, waste. But we bleeding. The thing boss for my mama, that me, the picking and no one bleeding at us. And I force and I see blood. But me, the blood who I see. If I get her, like the full of pit. But before we face shame all day, your man not press down. And the faith and the whip into the pieces and the quisser. Pick it, whip, pull and I go now. He leave mommy the faith. Faith, fortunately, the gates and the host will be near. Faith cannot go get taxi. Clown on a PCMH, I'm just going to call it a cottage. When the guy clown, they said, for go to BNC, but the guy on the corner, we woman go, we don't give comments. But when I saw that thing around me, when I got saved, now I understood the pain of the woman in your blood. But the life of every man is in your blood. You know, see, but before that woman bleed for 12 years, but me, I used to tell her in a church, say, I'm not a woman. But for me, some woman, they tell you, say, even when he reached the temple, he normal cycle, he went to pain full. Some woman at 3 days, some woman at 5 days, some way 10 to 1 week, he didn't even pray another each 1 week. But me, this woman, you know, for 12 years. Hey. Imagine commissioning. Imagine for 12 years. How come I get cycle? In 12 years, you only labor. Day and night. I listen to a man of God. The man of God said, the woman don't sell all that he gets just for any problem, no solution only. But if the woman don't go to every doctor, there was no solution. But if the woman don't go to all kind prayer meeting, all kind prayer house, all kind pastor, all kind anointing oil. Yet the blood was still flowing. And according to this man of God, he said that this woman was sent in a 1 green lapa. And he left that woman. But imagine what she did profusely, the girl in one lapa. So you know what the pastor said? He said the woman did tie the lapa during the day. The tie the lapa. So before they say 8 o'clock, he said, the blood will not pack in the lapa. He not get all the man. That next week, one sleep and take the worst in the lapa later. He sleep naked, that's by morning, the lapa will die. He took time. Bible say one day the woman will see Jesus in pass. But when the woman met by the kind way don't suffer the life, the woman said to herself, if I miss this opportunity, I don't try not to have nobody help me, but this one why they rebut. This one, if he pass me, well, give me your daughter. And the Bible said the woman decided to go on to Jesus. She did not wait for Jesus to come for her. Man of God. A lot of Christians are waiting for Jesus to come. Yes, she went to meet Jesus. Mommy, there is a level where you pressure the one that you didn't wait for money, you go for more. You don't even survive, mommy, you get boxed up for that church. You know what I like. It. Mommy, you are you better than the way you never better. Can't church, matter. I'll go next week. Wait where? Matter pass guy. Wait where you 47? Man, where are you? You can't retreat, like I said, no car, you can't buy this.
dit le cas naturel, qui vous restez amen. Je ne sais pas ce que continue. Parce que c'est cher l'église, je ne sais pas ce que l'on crie, continue.
Là, on devient pas sa mission. When the woman understand the level of the pressure and the humiliation and molestation we go through, she said to herself, this might be my opportunity. And look at what the Bible said. When you go read on to 35, and it's written to you, the Bible said, watch me. The woman decided to go after Jesus, for me. Not knowing that all this while, but what the woman with the firm solution, people that will not serve her. You know, when you know, when you get a problem, what can she enter? And they tell you, mommy, and us as a big Christian there, mommy, in time of pleasure, when you look for social, so why you go to mommy's house? Yes, baby. It's the same as a serious Christian believer, never. Mommy, some pleasure when you meet you. Every side that tells you, say, go, you go. You know, that's how it's about. Pray less on pleasure, look at you. Mommy, and in the course of looking for solution, all man knows are in woman. And the most of this kind of problem is. Mommy, when Jesus they pass, when the woman grabbed for unto Jesus, everybody say, hey, knock out up away. You don't say you dismay. That is how some of you, your condition is as I speak. Some man they tell you to your face. You don't get a physical bleeding. But believe you me, your life condition don't begin for smell. And the Bible says, as she was pressing towards Jesus, all man they push, say, madam, don't touch me. That blood really by you never can touch me. And she said, you know that you God teach me by this story? Do you know that when blood was on side flying, then they left me? For me, and they imagine when that woman they can't touch now, vroom, 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 vroom. It's on banda. Vroom, sabi ne banda dole de big fish, vroom, 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 vroom. Et vous, 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 that is what God is asking for some of you tonight. I don't know how many people around you in your family that are mocking you. They look at you today, they have things to say for hurt you, for make them molest you like. Bible says she never, watch me, she never turned and challenged them. She never turned and confronted them. She kept pressing. It was all them talking about God when I get solution. Apostle Suleiman said, nothing silent argument like evidence. So, you know, sometimes when you defend for people and believe you, now you tell me the ways, forget about those who are talking, go for evidence. Bible says she pressed unto the point that she could not come in face to face with Jesus. Young man, turn, just turn your back there, turn the other way. She came from the back. Jesus was pressing. Keep it like you're going, sir. And all of a sudden, mommy, the woman stretched and touched the end of Jesus' garment. Mommy, now after Jesus in close, then the woman touched. Bible said, the sooner the man touched the clothes, the woman noticed some shocking tear into her. The woman, what did happen to her? Mommy, when the woman opened the lamp, mommy, listen, when was he never shame? He didn't shame again. I believe I was not there, madam, favor. I believe, so the woman feel that sensation. And before all my opening, papa. For me, and when he opened the lamp, I realized the blood don't stop. The flow all don't stop. And watch what's happening. Then Jesus noticed that something not come out of my mouth. The Bible said, Jesus stopped beside the ground and said, somebody touched me. Jesus said, who touched me? That is what I'm trusting God for somebody tonight. That as someone they make fun with this service, yes,
you could be the one who stretch and touch Jesus. Jesus said, who touched me? And the Bible said, one of the disciples came to him and said, Master, see how many of us are here. We are many. All man they jam you, all man they rabble with you. You know, familiarity bring contempt. Yeah, this is mommy. People that they're close to Jesus. Mommy, I believe say people that they almost don't obscure Jesus, but nothing happened to me. You know what he do? Because if you know them who are skin with Jesus, well, their hearts will not connect to the power. Or in some man, they become so familiar at church that in the same way, I won't get the church. Informally, year by year, in the same way, I won't get the church. You go see stranger come up from Makenika a year in Miracle, and you go back. You day, sir, you the same way, I won't get the church. Jesus said, who touched me? They said, Master, many people are touching you. Jesus said, you don't understand. Many people are touching, but this is a special touch. This touch removes something from my life. It is a touch of faith. It is a touch that is looking for results. It is a touch that demands something. And the woman came and said, Master, it is I. Jesus looked at the woman. I'm coming to your faith, beat unto you. The woman left that place for me. Those people who were mocking her, they went home with their same problem. The woman who they been a monk will be able to go to you. Why are you here tonight? Why have you come tonight? What is that thing that you need God to do for you?
Yes,
is it about your marriage? Is it about your traveling? Is it about your business? Is it your job? You must demand to touch Jesus tonight.
Yes.
Rise up on the feet. I feel the fire of prayer tonight. The song said, you move mountain. Every mountain before my joy. Every mountain before my celebration.
Yes, sir.
Every mountain. There is somebody in church now. God is telling me that there is a mountain before your marriage in order for you not to enjoy that marriage. Some of you, it is the mountain that says you will never get into that marriage.
Yes, sir.
Every mountain that is before me.
Yes, sir.
Who art thou, O mountain before James? He said, for thou shalt become a blade. Am I talking to somebody tonight?
Yes, sir.
Are you ready to pray with me tonight?
Yes, sir.
Say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
My father, my fighter.
Father, my fighter.
As I pray tonight.
As I pray tonight.
Oh, God, my father.
Oh, God, my father.
Every mountain.
Every mountain.
Before my life.
Before my life.
Every mountain.
Every mountain.
Before my celebration.
Oh, yes,
every mountain.
Every mountain.
Before my joy.
Destiny.
Are you mountain?
Oh, mountain.
Fire the night.
Fire the night.
God said to me that after this prayer, there will be miracle jobs. I said there will be miracle jobs. What you never expect, God will bring them your way. Listen to the next prayer, pray along with me. Say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
Pray it out, say, my father, my fighter.
My father, my fighter.
As I pray tonight.
As I pray tonight.
Every obstacle to my breakthrough.
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 I overcome the mind of the country. Some of your life is the kind of effort will you make. You know, fever, the kind of results will they buy you. You work so hard, but there is a cost of leaking blessing. People will bless her, but those blessings must not affect her in any way. I told you it was yesterday service, man of God. I can't remember if it was yesterday or Thursday. It was Thursday Bible study about a pastor I used to know. He's a friend of mine. This pastor was working. Mommy, if I tell you the office where they tell you the prayer, mommy, every month the pastor like they to heavy debt. Very prayerful person. Very spiritual person. Every month he like they to in the world I would have one day. Many years after he don't explain to me, long after, then God said to me, say, You don't understand. He said, if you check almost the past this fire and every month. If even able for employee person, the person survive. But imagine if me for being an employee to person or employee person,
Imagine you almost crossed me and defied him for purpose. But can I shock you? The life of the man was full of debts every month. Check where there was a cause of leaking blessing. The blessing will come, but it will not stay. Mommy, some money day, when you leave me, you hear the answer. Put an answer on my hand, mommy, get 2 months, go ask her back for me. That story, you know what you're going to tell me. Mommy, some people in there, some of you are even under the sound of my voice, that some huge money has been placed in your hand. And sometimes, if you tell me, if you fly in the water, say, sister, that kind of money day, mommy, you said, no, you explain how all that they waste come on a man. Because of little blessing.
Hey.
This is our final prayer tonight. Man of God, I can't labor for nothing. I can't walk like an elephant and eat like an ant. I can't live a stressful life, yet my life is in poverty.
Yes, sir.
That curse must be broken tonight. Lift up your voice and pray with me. Say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
My father, my fighter.
My father, my fighter.
As I pray tonight.
As I pray tonight.
At the cross of leaking blessing.
At the cross of leaking blessing.
Over my life.
Over my life.
At the cross of leaking blessing.
At the cross of leaking
blessing. As for my destiny. Of God upon my life, I close you by the blood of Jesus. I pray for all of you today under the sound of my voice. Every leakage in your life to bring you under financial embarrassment, I close
lost it today in the name of Jesus. As you stand before me, I pray for you today. Every root that the enemy is using to cause a leakage, every root the enemy is using to mess up with your life, that even people that gave you the money never believe you again.
Yes, sir.
Let that embarrassment stop from today. Stretch your hand before you. As I anoint your hands,
oh God.
As I anoint your hands, as I anoint your right hand, in the name of Jesus, from today, no more financial embarrassment again.
No more.
I said, no more financial embarrassment again.
No more.
No more financial embarrassment again.
No more.
No more financial embarrassment again.
No more.
In the name of Jesus. Everybody behind, stretch your hand in front of them. He says, stretch your hand before you. And closing, I don't be a spectator. What God is saying to one, he's saying to all. What God is saying to one, some of you did not put the money into business, but money had entered your hand. And they tell you by this time, level for don't change. But when you look at your life today, you keep wondering, where did it go wrong? I pray for you today.
Yes, sir.
I hear God saying to me, restoration is coming.
Amen.
I hear heaven saying to me, restoration is coming.
Amen.
He said, for I will restore to you the ears,
yes,
that the locusts, the cat cowl, and the caterpillar is eating.
Uh-huh.
He said, I will restore. Let there be restoration in your way in the name of Jesus. From today, may God restore your financial life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let your finances be restored again in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
To empty your business, every root the devil is using to empty your business, I close it today with the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
I close it today with the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
It shall never be your portion in life again.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus, thank you, Father, for what you have done.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Lift up your voice and begin to bless him. Somebody, bless him.